the nightmare stalk of the Cambrian seas. Imagine swimming in a primordial ocean 500 million years ago, where the water is a murky soup of death and chaos. Something moves in the dark, a creature with a segmented body, writhing like a fever dream. It's Opabinia, and it's watching you with five glowing eyes, each one a bead of unblinking malice. Its long, flexible proboscis, think a vacuum cleaner hose with claws, snaps toward you, probing the water for flesh. This thing isn't just a predator, it's a psychological horror show, slithering through the Cambrian seas like a living question mark. Those five eyes, asymmetrically plastered on its head, don't just see you, they dissect you, tracking your every twitch. Scientists say its vision was likely primitive, but who needs HD when you've got five lenses to haunt your prey? The proboscis, a grotesque mix of dexterity and menace, could snatch trilobites like a kid grabbing candy. Fossils from the Burgess Shale show this thing was built to terrify. Its body a mix of soft lobes and armored plates, like nature couldn't decide if it was a worm or a tank. Every movement screams, I was born to unsettle. And the worst part, this freak was one of evolution's first drafts, a prototype predator that makes modern sharks look like they're on a leash. Five eyes, zero chill. Oh, like Opabinia, the Cambrian's resident overachiever, strutting around with five eyes like it's auditioning for an alien horror flick. Why settle for two when you can have a whole pentagon of peepers, right? This thing's head is basically a disco ball of bad decisions, each eye glaring in a different direction like it's trying to win a staring contest with the entire ocean. And that proboscis? Please, it's like evolution handed Opabinia a Swiss army knife and said, go wild, but make it creepy. This glorified snorkel could bend and twist to snatch prey, probably while Opabinia cackled. Bet you didn't see that coming. Scientists think those eyes gave it a panoramic view of the seafloor, perfect for spotting snacks. But let's be real, with that many eyes, it was probably just paranoid, jumping at every shadow like a caffeinated conspiracy theorist. The Burgess Shale fossils show it had a body like a vacuum cleaner bag with fin sleek. But in a, who invited this guy? Way, honestly, Opabinia was the Cambrian's try hard, over-designate and overcompensating for something. Proboscis of pure pettiness. Let's talk about Opabinia's proboscis, because apparently evolution thought, what if we gave a shrimp a grabby straw with teeth? This thing's front-end weapon was a 3-inch nightmare tube, complete with a claw to yoink prey like it's running a claw machine at a cursed arcade. Picture it. Opabinia, floating in the Cambrian muck, spotting a juicy trilobite and thinking, mine, before its proboscis lashes out like a passive-aggressive librarian shushing you with a cattle prod. Scientists say this appendage was a game-changer, letting Opabinia hunt with precision while its five eyes played 360-degree I spy. But let's not kid ourselves, this wasn't elegance. It was pettiness in motion. That proboscis didn't just grab food. It probably flicked sand in the faces of rival critters, just because it could. The fossils suggest it was flexible enough to reach around obstacles, which is code for Opabinia was the ultimate jerk at the Cambrian buffet. And for all its swagger, this thing was only a foot long, proof you don't need size to be a menace. It's like nature made a tiny, spiteful vacuum cleaner and called it a predator. Cambrian chaos machine. Behold the Opabinia, you fools. Nature's unhinged fever dream cooked up in the Cambrian explosion's mad science lab. Five eyes? A clawed snorkel? This thing's a walking war crime against normalcy. Picture the scene. 500 million years ago, evolution's throwing darts at a board labeled weird, and Opabinia is the bullseye. Those five eyes five aren't just there to creep you out. They're a panoramic death radar, scanning the ocean floor for anything dumb enough to wiggle. Fossils from the Burgess Shale scream over-engineered menace, with a body like a segmented submarine, flapping lobes to swim, and that proboscis, oh, that proboscis. It's a biomechanical harpoon, snatching prey with the precision of a deranged puppeteer. Scientists, in their boring lab coats, mumble about predatory adaptations, but this is no mere hunter, this is chaos incarnate. A creature that looked at trilobites and thought, snack time, losers. Its nervous system? Probably a tangle of wires sparking with bad ideas. The Cambrian was a free-for-all, and Opabinia was the kid flipping the board, laughing as the pieces scattered. It didn't just survive. It thrived in a world where normal was a dirty word. The five-eyed freak's legacy. Strap in. Because Opabinia isn't just a fossil, it's a cosmic middle finger, everything we thought we knew about life. Five eyes, people, five. Each one a glowing orb of, what even is this? Staring into the Cambrian void. This thing was a predator, sure, but it was also evolution's manic test run, a prototype for every nightmare creature that followed. It's Proboscis, a grabby, toothy hose that screamed, I'll eat you and your feelings. Fossils show it had 30 segments, each a little plate of try me armor, swimming with lobes that flapped like a possessed accordion. Scientists drool over its arthropod-like features, but let's get real. This was no shrimp cousin, it was a glitch in the matrix, a bug in nature's code. Those eyes weren't just for hunting, they were for dominating the Cambrian psyche, making every other creature question their life choices. And the kicker? Opabinia went extinct. But its DNA whispers in every creepy crawly today, from spiders to scorpions. It's like it laughed. You can't kill this vibe. As it vanished, leaving us to pick up the pieces of its unhinged legacy. That's it for today. I've got more freaky evolution videos coming, so smash that subscribe button and stay weird.